Okay, so it's no secret that Hanukkah, the festival of lights, doesn't hold a candle to Christmas. Christmas, 450,000 multicolored strobe lights pulsing and flashing over every square inch of the house and lawn. Hanukkah, at its climax, nine spindly candles that burn out before you've even stopped gawking at the glowing reindeer galloping across the neighbor's roof. Christmas, honey-baked ham, ginger brisket, crusted tenderloin, cheesy stuffed potatoes, caramelized acorn squash, oyster stuffing, sugar cookies, pecan pie, rice pudding. Hanukkah, latkes. Look, why even compare? Christmas is Beyoncé, Hanukkah is, I don't know, Mr. Bean. But then again, maybe not. Because what Hanukkah lacks in glitter and panache, it makes up in the power of its historical narrative. The year is 167 BC. The Syrian tyrant Antiochus Epiphanes is hell-bent on destroying the Jewish people. A revolt breaks out, and 10,000 crudely armed Jewish civilians go up against 65,000 of the most powerful troops on the planet. Impossible odds. And if you know anything about the God of Israel, he loves those odds. As King David put it in Psalm 2, the kings of the earth set themselves against the Lord and against his Messiah, saying, "Let us break their bonds in pieces and cast away their cords." But he who sits in the heavens shall laugh. And so God defeats the armies of Antiochus, rescuing the Jewish people from annihilation, enabling them to restore the temple and resume worship. If it weren't for Hanukkah, the Jewish nation would have become extinct 2,000 years ago. If it weren't for Hanukkah, Israel's Messiah wouldn't have been born in Bethlehem 160 years later. Which means, if it weren't for Hanukkah, there wouldn't be a Christmas. Huh. Maybe Hanukkah is Beyoncé after all.